going to pull over and tell you that we are going to investigate, first up, whether Google just killed GPS. For those of you who don't know, last week Google launched a new feature for their mobile maps, and that is a location tracker. In spite of the fact that you don't have GPS on your phone, like this particular BlackBerry has no GPS, yet when I go to Google Maps, it actually shows me a blue beeping dot as to where I am in Mumbai. How does it do that? Well, simple. It picks up the signal from the nearest cell phone tower. Okay, I'm at a red light, so I'm going to do the first logical thing, which is map a route for myself. I put the start point as my current location and the end point as my office, and I ask it for directions. Whoops, it tells me no route found, even though there are obviously lots of routes. So that's the first thing bad about this, is that at least in India, the maps don't seem to be good enough for it to actually give you directions. Okay, the signal is opening up, so I'm going to just have to figure it out myself. So I must say that I'm impressed by the accuracy of this, at least in parts of Bombay or other big cities where there's enough density of cell phone towers. It sometimes gives you your location right down to 3 meter accuracy, and the blip actually moves along with you on the road as you move. So it gives you a fair idea of where you are. In places where there aren't enough cell phone towers, the density can be as low as giving you your approximate location in a 5 kilometer radius, which is quite useless. Well, in the final analysis, this has the same problem as GPS, and that is, it doesn't tell you, A, whether roads have become one way or not, and it doesn't tell you, like in the case of this road, whether the road is so bumpy that it's not worth taking. So anyway, I'm getting a very approximate location up to 1700 meters or 1.7 kilometers as to where I am. I just have to ask somebody for very specific directions, and then I'll find my way. So, has Google killed GPS? Well, in a way, they've killed casual GPS, because nobody who wanted GPS just for the cool factor will need to buy a GPS phone anymore. They know where they are. If your life depends on it, like if you're a professional trucker or a professional rally driver, then you'd still want accurate GPS, because this isn't always telling you exactly where you are, which is critical if you want to get from point A to B in a city that you have no idea about.